eight ball corner pocket.
Whose idea was this, Charlie?
Niven's. And you're gonna have to clear the area, Jim. We're here to question these two.
He's got no business in here.
Take it up with the colonel.
This is Captain Davenport. You both understand you're to give the captain your full cooperation.
You're a lawyer, huh?
I'm not here to answer your questions, Lieutenant. Sit down. Sit down.
Yes, sir.
When did you last see Sergeant Waters?
Same night somebody killed him. Of course, I should have done it myself, by the way. He spoke to Wilcox and me.
And how did he speak to you, Captain?
Well, he was drunk. Said a few things he shouldn't have. And I told the Lieutenant here not to make the situation any worse than it already was, so we just left him there on the side of the road, on his knees.
Alive.
Exactly what did he say?
Well, he said he wasn't going to obey the white man's orders anymore. Then he starts blaming Wilcox and me for him being black. I mean, imagine that, huh? Hell, I didn't even know the man.
Yeah, and he said he killed somebody, too. And some pretty insulting things about us. I mean, white officers.
Did he say who? Mention a name?
Look, the goddamn nigger was disrespectful. Now, no way does a colored soldier speak to a white officer like that. What the hell are we doing wasting time on this, huh?
You answer him like he wants you to, Bird, or I'll stick it to your ass every chance I get. You got that?
Yes, sir.
Captain, let me handle this.
Then handle it!
You said he was disrespectful. Is that why you killed him?
I killed no one.
Sit down. Now, you hit him, didn't you?
I knocked him down.
Then you shot him.
He was alive when we left.
You beat him up, you went back, and you shot him.
No! And you get out of my face, boy, if I kill you.
Like you killed Waters.
No! Soldier! Trying to put it on me, Captain.
Sit down.
Answer his questions, Lieutenant.
You were both coming off bivouac, right? Speak up, Captain. You both had weapons.
But we didn't fire him.
When'd you turn him in?
Right away, sir. Colonel Nivens took our 45s to the MPs. See, he wanted to keep it quiet because he didn't want the colored boys to know anybody white from the fort was involved, but those weapons cleared ballistics.
Besides, we've been short on 45 caliber ammo for, what, 6 months? It's for MPs and special duty people only. Look, nobody on that exercise was issued any.
What?
I said, sir, nobody on the bivouac was issued any 45 ammo.
I don't believe you. Why wasn't I told?
Well, the weapons had already cleared, and the colonel felt that if he involved you any further, you'd go to Washington with it, which, as it turns out, he thinks you did anyway. Sir, I just want to say, we were not involved in any way whatsoever with the sergeant's death. Now, I'm a doctor. We left that man on the side of the road alive.
Consider yourselves under arrest, gentlemen. The charge is murder.
Captain, you think I believe that crap?
Let him go.
What?
Will you be in charge?
Not by me.
What are you doing? You've got a motive, you've got a witness, I mean, what more do you want?
This is still my investigation, Charlie. We've both been had, Captain. The colonel knew this all along. I've been marching around in circles.
They are as guilty as hell, and you know it. Now, I'll back you up, charge them.
I do what the facts tell me, Captain, not you.
You don't know what a fact is, Davenport.
I'm the lawyer. They teach you law at West Point?
You don't have to be a goddamn lawyer to deal with those two assholes. And if they didn't kill Waters, who did?
I don't know yet.